Greetings, Mr. Strauss. Interesting decor you've got here. I like that. How goes it?
Greetings, Neonate. Might I assume you received my invitation? I have been looking forward to meeting you for quite some time.
Yeah, I got it. I'm assuming you are...
Strauss. Maximillian Strauss. I am the regent of this chantry. Welcome.
Thanks. What is this place?
Ah, yes. Forgive me. I forget that you are not embraced within the pyramid.
It was a pyramid again.
We share the same blood, you and I. But there is much you have yet to learn about our clan.
You're of the Tremere clan?
Yes. This new life in which you find yourself undoubtedly seems strange. I'm sure you have many questions, young one. I will answer those which I am able.
What do you mean, embrace within the pyramid? He means the whole, Camarilla period thing, that pyramid thing that they were, what do you call it? Nines Rodriguez was just talking about?
The pyramid is the social structure of our clan, with each level of advancement watched over by the next.
Okay, different
there
pyramid.
There are apprentices here at the Chantry who are my charges, and I have a lord who watches over me and other local regents, and so on. In most cases, Tremere are very selective about who they embrace and how it is done. There are traditions and laws that we adhere to, so the circumstances of your embrace were, let us say, unconventional. Therefore, you are outside the pyramid.
Hmm. I see. Can I get inside the pyramid? Be an apprentice, maybe?
Such things are possible, young one, but you would have to prove your worth to the clan before it would even be a consideration. Tremere guard their secrets well. Perhaps it is something we will speak of later.
Hmm. Well, I think I might know a few of your secrets and use them myself. I see. Tell me what a chantry is.
A chantry is a local gathering place for those of the Tremere clan. I live here, as do apprentices from time to time.
Cool. And you're a regent? What is that?
A regent is the leader of a chantry, as well as a teacher to young Tremere apprentices who are studying the mysteries of our clan.
Hmm. I'm new around here, Max. Can I call you Max? What's the word on the street?
Let me give you some advice, young one. Your survival in kindred society will often depend on your ability to find out yourself what is going on around you. Remember that well.
Okay. I appreciate the advice.
As for what is going on here in downtown, the word on everyone's lips, kindred or kind, seems to be epidemic.
Yeah? Why? What's going on?
It seems that disease has been spreading at an alarming rate throughout the downtown population. Considering our particular appetites, the local kindred are more than concerned about these developments.
Interesting.
Yes, indeed. My opinion is that the local anarchs are responsible for these outbreaks. Their precipitous indulgence of certain passions often leads to such things. Ergo, their need for the watchful eye of the Camarilla.
Camarilla? What's that all about?
The Camarilla. It is merely a kindred sect that exists to protect its members from the outside world. There are specific codes of behavior that we abide by in order to ensure the continuance of our species. It is nothing more and nothing less.
I see. Can I ask you a few more questions about the Camarilla?
Surely. What else would you like to know?
Yeah. I already know the answers to 1 and 2. Not necessarily 3, but I want to hear what he has to say about it. Are all vampires a part of the Camarilla?
No. There are many independent clans who are not aligned with the Camarilla. And the Sabbat is another sect of various vampire clans whose beliefs are very different than our own. Unsavory sorts, to say the least. I understand you have already run afoul of them.
Yes, I have. I actually felt stupid just asking that question. Yeah, good thing Nines Rodriguez was there to help me out.
Ah, yes. The infamous Mr. Rodriguez. I understand you owe him your life twice now. Had he not intervened, the prince would have surely had that hound of his separate your head from your shoulders.
Hmm. You're probably right.
In any case, it's a shame that Rodriguez cannot see the wisdom of the Camarilla. He would make a powerful ally. As it is, he is a significant thorn in LaCroix's side, which serves my purposes just the same.
It does? Your purposes? Yeah, I'm just surprised. Your purposes? Aren't your purposes and the prince's the same?
LaCroix is a prince, neonate, and a ventrue on top of that. Even if he weren't as young and indiscriminate as he's already proven himself to be, But I say too much. Let us just say that he and I have differing ideas on the use of power.
His, jacket looks like it's made out of metal. It's all right, you can trust me. What's your true opinion of him?
I have overstepped my bounds. I will say no more.
Fine, tell me more of the Camarilla.
Surely. What else would you like to know?
Why aren't the Anarchs in the Camarilla?
The Anarchs feel that they don't need the structure and discipline of the Camarilla. I feel that they pose a threat, both to those loyal to the Camarilla and to themselves. Most are mere children and need our guidance. Surely. What else would you like to know?
Let's try again. What do you think of Prince LaCroix?
LaCroix is a prince, neonate, and a venture.
Don't want to feel I'm pushing it if I choose the second option, and I've already chosen the first. I have more questions, but not about the Camarilla.
Surely. What else would you like to know? Of course.
I have a few questions for you.
What is it you would like to know?
Oh.
Of course.
Okay. Maybe I can look into the epidemic for you.
An interesting proposition. If you succeed in finding the cause of this epidemic and putting an end to it, I will compensate you appropriately for your efforts.
What's in it for me?
I will ponder the nature of your payment while you are gone. Believe me, I will treat you fairly, neonate, and your service to the Camarilla won't be forgotten.
All right, I'll take care of it.
Very well.
See if there's any more questions.
What is it you would like to know? Of course.
All right. All of a sudden, he's finding his artwork to be very interesting. You are looking into the cause of the epidemic for the Camarilla as well as the Anarchs. Vested interest and all that. See that? It's teleporting me. Like, there's some place he doesn't want me to go. I don't suppose I can get upstairs still. No. Alright, that's interesting. Maximillian Strauss. Return to your haven frequently to check your email. I've done that once. Too bad I don't have a portable. Maybe, oh, there's another one of those symbols. Maybe in the second game we'll have a mobile phone. What's this? Oh, it's a broken down. Is that where the library is? Library? No, it doesn't look like. But I'll take a look. Die, my darling. Oh, hi. What's this place?
What's up, sister? You enlightened?
No.
Sorry, sister. Come back when you've become enlightened.
Jumbles?
You enlightened yet, sister?
Yeah?
Sorry, sister. Come back when you've become enlightened.
Okay, I'm enlightened now.
You enlightened yet, sister?
Yeah?
Sorry, sister. Come back when you've become enlightened.
Should've said yeah the first time. Your flowers died. I'll have to remember what the hell this place is. But where it is, well, I don't know what it is, but where it is. So that is nothing.
Lovely evening.
Bless you. Alright, this is where we started out. I think over here. We can get in here. There's a hole in the fence somewhere. Yeah, I haven't checked it out yet, so let's check. You already have a weapon? Someone died over here. Clan Bruja. Largely composed of rebels, both with and without causes. Oh, this is gun area. Is this where the hospital was? Should I be sneaking?
Help me! Help me! It's got them! It's coming for me now! It's coming for me!
I'm tempted to say, to pick the last one. Slow down. What's coming? Who are you?
My crew. We were here shooting for my show. I'm a parapsychologist. Haunted LA. Oh, God, it was right behind me.
We've Ghosty?
Out of here.
I'm about to slap some sense into you. Tell me what happened.
Look, I'll level with you. We usually fake these things, you know, ghosts, that's all bullshit. We were setting up downstairs, and weird shit started happening. My crew, they all started disappearing. I don't know what's happening.
Trying to read a shirt. It's a six, says haunted. Probably haunted LA logo. Wait here. I'll go see if I can find them.
No, don't go down there. We've got to get out. It's coming. It's coming!
Oh my God. Get a grip on yourself. You're a parapsychologist. You deal with this stuff all the time unless you're just an actor. Did he run out or did he run this way? Oh, he ran out over here.
No, I'm perfectly sane. That's right, I'm fine. No, I didn't see that. No, it never happened. None of it.
It never happened.
No, it was out of nowhere.
Right. You stay here and mumble incoherently. I'll be back. Let alone just to come in here for that. So this must be the site of an old hospital. So we got more ghost stuff going on here, or could it be something else? Because we've done the ghost thing before. I think this hospital has seen better days. I think I could shake any of these boards loose or anything. Past all this crap. Nah. Damn automatic closing doors. Damn you! I'm trying to get it out of the room. It's not working out for me. Can I turn it? Bump it against something? That's, oh god. I wanted to throw it at this stuff here, but I don't think it's... Yeah, that's what you call, Half-Life physics. Source engine. I don't know how to get any further in here. I might. I can't just break down the wall. I'm a vampire, damn it. Well, let me try this on that stuff out there. Never mind.
This is crazy. I'm crazy.
You probably are crazy. Looks very familiar, too. Let's take a look around the rest of the building so you can find another way in, maybe? Otherwise, this guy's just gonna have to wait till I find out a way to get inside that tunnel. Oh, I might have to take the tunnels to get through there. I don't feel like doing that just yet. Because there's someone down there I'm gonna have to fight. I approve of your outfit. I approve.
Not now.
I do approve right now of your outfit. Okay. Alright, so where am I again? Where am I headed? This is... Okay, I'm headed back to where I was. I need to go back that way. Oh, you get around fast. Yeah, let's go talk to LaCroix. I don't really trust LaCroix, so I'm not going to be giving away too much of the stuff that we learned from others. At least I don't plan on it. Hey, these were open at one point. Not working. So that is working, huh? Some of them indicate they're not working, and some of them. This was the one that was open, I thought. Was those coming from the other way? That's a no. That's an unknown. That's a no there. Unknown there. How do I get to talk to this guy? All these doors didn't work. Unless it's closed off because I talked to Rodriguez first. That would be lame, though. I can't report back to him. I don't have any failed quests. Report to Prince LaCroix at the Venture Tower downtown. I'm trying to do that. Maybe he needs to let me up again. Maybe I need to talk to him again.
Yeah, you go right on up and see Mr. LaCroix. Ah, let's see what we got on good old camera 3. Oh, well, hello there. I've been thinking about you. Oh, yeah. I want to lick you all over. Then make my way down to your creamy center and...
What?
What the... Get your hands off my Bavarian cream!
What does this mean? This is a light switch. On him. Oh, not anymore. Wait.
Get your hands off that.
Sorry. I guess I tried to grab his gun? Or I hit the panic switch or something. Is there a panic switch? Let's try the elevators again, I guess. I don't know. Oh, now it's open. Alright. So confirm this is what we have to do. Can't hit anything other than penthouse. Oh, what do we call him? Brute or something? The brute? forget. Nice fire. All the comforts of home. Don't want to break the china. All that fun stuff. Nice picture. Okay. Hi, big guy. You're very tall. Oh, nice view. Hola.
There you are. I was informed of your presence in the building. Since you're here, I'll take the liberty of assuming you've destroyed the warehouse. This is correct, yes?
Yes, that is...
Most excellent. I had no doubt you'd prove my decision a prudent one. I trust you encountered no impediments to your progress on account of my personnel.
Give me time to spend some experience points. I'm not gonna rat out Mercurio. He's nice enough, seems it anyway. Santa Monica Kindred. Oh! I get what I'm saying here. We promised not to give away that secret. So, I mean, even though this is a hint, he might ask where we're going with this, or it might be enough of a hint for him to figure out or to confirm his suspicion. So I'm just gonna say none. None at all, because I don't wanna give away Jeanette slash Teresa's, or I guess just Teresa's secret. I did say we're gonna keep their secret there, so yeah, none at all.
That is the answer I like to hear. You've done well, circumstances being what they were. I will admit, not many in your position would have overcome such a trial. But don't misunderstand me. It was no fool's errand. You may yet prove to be a genuine asset. It's a bit disturbing, the lack of talent within this organization as of late. Tell me, what would you say to doing a bit of reconnaissance for me?
What's in it for me?
Don't be so hasty to inflate your own worth.
Heck.
You've succeeded once, very admirable. But in the grand scheme of it all, an infant's stride of progress. If you're looking to make a name for yourself, listen very carefully. There have been whispers, rumors spreading around the Kindred community concerning the Elizabeth Dane.
Right.
The cargo ship that was towed into port recently. Have you heard of it?
We did see something about that on the news. But I want to hear what he's going to say about it, so no, I haven't. What about it?
The Dane was found out at sea. The reports say it was without crew, but they have yet to report a fate of said crew. The police are investigating the Dane as we speak. Even the Nosferatu have little information on what's been found. However, the reason the ship has caused such speculation is because it was transporting an object called the Onkaran sarcophagus. Now, I'm not one to predicate a decision based on conjecture, so what I need is fact. And more importantly, I need evidence that the occurrences on the Dane were not supernatural in nature, and in no way relate to this Onkaran sarcophagus.
I have a feeling that they do relate to the Onkaran sarcophagus. What do you need me to do?
You have three objectives. One, I want you to examine the sarcophagus for anything unusual. You may sense something peculiar about the sarcophagus. In fact, many kindred in the city have reported an uneasiness in the air since the Dane's arrival. Do not, under any circumstances, open the Onkaran sarcophagus.
Yep.
Secondly, the police have begun their investigation. Find out what they have concluded thus far. Thirdly, take the cargo manifest for the ship. I want to find out what else it was carrying. The last thing we want is police aware of our existence, so be careful what you do in front of them. And unlike the warehouse, you cannot wholesale slaughter a ship full of lawmen without consequences. Is this understood?
Well, he did say that he wanted us to find out if this did or did not have anything to do with the sarcophagus. Then he's telling us to investigate the sarcophagus. Which means it does have something to do with the sarcophagus. So make up your mind, guy. Does it or does it not? And the way he's wording it afterwards is pretty much a given that there is a sarcophagus there. But, yes.
Good. Oh. And it has come to my attention that you had an encounter with Nines Rodriguez earlier. The man so does love to throw that cretinous charm of his brashly about. What exactly did Mr. Rodriguez say?
Here's what he said. Now, if I choose number one... Remember, I'm playing this blind. I don't know if I choose number one and I'm going to get an option of different things. You know, other than what is listed here. Or if choosing number one tells... him exactly everything he told us. So, just in case it's one, I'm gonna say some nonsense about the Anorex. I didn't listen very carefully.
If I may give you a piece of advice, always listen to others' words carefully. Read between the lines, gauge where you stand with them and who they decry or exalt. The more you know about someone, the greater your advantage. Now that that's out of the way, I trust you're prepared to leave for the Dane.
I don't want to do it yet. I do want to ask him questions. I still have something I have to do. I'll do it later.
Good. I'm counting on an encore exposition of the talent you showed earlier. Go. And remember, under no circumstances are you to open the Ankaran sarcophagus. We'll talk later. Good. There's a boat waiting for you on the beach in Santa Monica.
Okay. Who's in the sarcophagus? Kane? Let's see if I can ask him some questions other than just I'm ready to go or not.
I can't stress the urgency of this task enough. Good. Good.
Good. I'm just going to save here. I want to make sure I don't get transported there. I do want to ask him some questions.
I can't stress the urgency.
I'm ready to go, but I had some questions first.
I suppose I can spare a few seconds.
I had some questions about people.
Yes.
Yourself.
It's common knowledge. I was born in Calais, France, over 200 years ago. When I graduated from the Royal Military Academy, I joined Napoleon's army. It was shortly after Waterloo when I was embraced by a Belgian noble. From that time onward, I counted some of the greatest kindred in Europe as my mentors and worked towards establishing a Camarilla presence in new territories. In 1930, I came to the Americas and staked power in New York. Soon after, I headed west to claim domain.
Yeah, back to the Great Depression days again, or almost. This is the stupidest question ever. What clan are you?
I'm Ventru. But I don't disparage any of the other clans. All are equally important in maintaining the foundations of the Camarilla, and the elders of each serve as my council.
Okay, yeah, actually the most stupidest questions would be to ask him what sect he's from. That's what I thought. So the clan is Ventru. Yeah, we knew that anyway. At least I did. I had questions about someone else.
Yes.
Yes. Beckett.
You've met Beckett? Yes. He did pay me the courtesy of announcing his presence in my city. He's lionized in kindred society, by most. Beckett's the definition of renowned scholar, but he's also a lone wolf, and owes allegiance only to his intellectual pursuits.
So he's an intellectual gangrel. It's kind of an oddity. Seems Beckett is unique. I had questions about someone else.
Yes.
Jack.
The man is a scourge. The physical manifestation of chaos. Whenever he makes an appearance in one city, it is only a matter of time before a calamity is attributed to his latest lark. Yes?
Tell me about that guy standing behind you.
He's my sheriff. When there is a problem that words are wasted on, I send him. The less one sees of him, the better.
I can only imagine.
Yes?
That's all the people. I had a question about something else.
Which is?
The Camarilla.
In this age of information, videotape, and weapons of mass destruction, the Camarilla is more necessary than it has ever been.
Mass destruction.
The alternative to thorough secrecy these days is extinction. As long as we exist, so shall kindred society. Which is...
Tell me about the Sabbat.
Every night you wake up, be thankful you were not sired by one of their kind. Or you would have woken under the ground, forced to claw your way up from the dirt into a brief, bloody, violent existence. Savages. Bloodthirsty, irresponsible heathens. Which is...
Tell me about the Ankaran sarcophagus.
All I know about the Ankaran sarcophagus is what I've heard on the news. It was found during an archaeological excavation in Turkey, and it appears ancient. There could be nothing but dust inside. However, that does not discount the possibility of it containing some kindred artifact, or even a mummy. All of these evidence of the supernatural, and therefore potentially damaging to us. As for it containing an ancient kindred, the Camarilla does not put stock in the actuality of antediluvians. They're myths. Don't let anyone tell you differently.
That's all the questions I have for now. Bye. The less I see of you, the better. I believe it. Can I ask him anything else?
Yeah, you go right on up and see Mr. LaCroix. Cover me, Tubbs!
Must have dozed after a minute.
You were just talking to me. Okay, the prince wants you to investigate the Elizabeth Dane. You need to go to the beach in Santa Monica, where a boat will be waiting to take you out to the ship. You are to examine the Ankaran sarcophagus, find out what the police have discovered, and take the cargo manifest for the ship. And above all, try not to go on a killing spree. Alright. Purely stealth mission. Don't kill anyone. Feed, I suppose, and that's it. But that will be... Well, not even the next episode, because I'm going to finish looking around. We still have to go to the Skyline Hotel. I'm not sure where else we have to go besides that. Because there's two objectives there we have to check out. So thanks so much for watching. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.